Then it starts officially. So I just want to wait for Timo Kovan. So he is my assistant tonight for making the sales part at the end of the webinar. And today or tonight's topic is money management, how it works, what are the myths, and what are the expectations about return on investment, and so on. So let's start. These are the five subtopics tonight. So the risk per trade, drawdown and recovery, position size, the optimal position size and how to calculate it, leverage, then what is a winning system and how can I recognize it, and the yearly return and expectations about yearly return. Okay, then let's start. Or maybe you have some questions right now, then please use the chat box at any time, and I will answer your questions immediately. Okay, but for now, I cannot see any questions, so let's start with the first real slide. So, which risk per trade is okay? This is a question a lot of traders ask themselves, and most of them, especially beginners and newbies, come to the conclusion that maybe 5% or 4 or maybe 6% per trade to risk is okay, because the higher the risk, the better and the higher is the return. But you have to be very carefully with this kind of approach to more risk to get more, because you destroy your bankroll, your trading account, and this is not helpful. So for this reason, we want to clarify the questions: are 5% acceptable or too high? And this depends on what you want to achieve and what return you want to generate. As I said before, the higher the risk, the higher the potential return. This is true, but you have to consider how much risk you want to take and not lose all your money and destroy your bank account. So, however, one should not risk the total loss. Yeah? And this is pretty easy. If you take too high risk, let's say 10% per trade is way too much. And the probability of total loss is very high if you risk 10% on each trade you make. Yeah? With little money, whose loss is manageable, you can also take higher risk. For large accounts, capital preservation is the focus and the risk should be very small. So what I mean by that, or the replacement value of the money is very, very important. For example, assume you have $5,000 and you just open a trading account with $100. So it's just a part of your money. And it is not that hard to get $100 from your other account, or you can earn it in your profession. And then, of course, you can risk more, because $100 is not that important to you as maybe $20,000. So the replacement value of money plays an important role. So now Timo is here, so let me give him the rights to be a moderator and turn his microphone on. And now he should be able to speak as well. But okay, carry on here. So regarding and considering all these aspects, I would say 5% is way too much. Hi.
Hi,
No,
hi, Matthias. Sorry for the delay. Really, sorry, sorry.
no problem, no worry.
I hope you mercy me. I think this is the second pizza that I have to serve for you.
Hopefully.
Hopefully. Okay. Good. Great stuff. Good.
Okay. Yeah, and then the next question, or the next statement you can read here, is 1 to 2% is a reasonable money management. And I would highlight this, and I would underscore this, because in my trading world, a risk of 1% is okay. And sometimes you find some very, very good and profitable spots, and then of course you can risk more, 2%, maybe 3%, but 3% or more shouldn't be your default risk. So please go lower with your risk only 1 until 2% per trade, and then everything should be okay. So for example, you can see the last two sentences. If you lose 10 trades in a row, and I can tell you this happens from time to time, even 20 trades in a row can be a loser. So this is not a fairy tale. So these things happen, I can tell you. And you only risk 1% in this kind of drawdown, then you are losing only about 10% of the trading account. And this is okay. But if you lose 10 trades in a row with a risk of 5% per trade, then you are losing about 50% of your trading account. And this is way too much. And why is this way too much? You can see this here, recovery needed to get back to the break even. So imagine you trading with a 5% risk per trade, and then you are losing 10 trades in a row. Then your total loss is 40%. And to get back to the starting point, you need to make a return for 67%. Yeah, and a 67% return is really good. So it's a challenge to get this return. Or let's say 6%. You're losing 10 trades in a row, then your total loss is 46%. Then you need to make 86% just to go back to the starting point. And for these reasons, you can see pretty easily that maybe risking 1 or 2% is pretty good, because then you are recovering in a shorter period of time and you only need to make 11 or 22% to get back to the starting point. So to survive a drawdown and to make more losing trades in a row than you are in a drawdown, it is important to minimize the risk per trade. So is this clear to you, or do you have any questions regarding the money management and risk per trade we are talking about?
Matthias, everything sounds clear. Very good. Thanks.
Okay, but somebody is writing something in the chat box. This is clear. Okay, thanks. Okay, yeah, then let's continue. So I have some more things for you. So for example, the position size. Most of the beginners completely ignore the correct and the optimal position size. They only enter a trade and then they're saying something like, okay, it goes right, then I make money. If it goes wrong, then I lose money. But I don't care about how much I can lose. So I'm just making the trade. But this statement is really, really dangerous. So you are much better if you improve your position sizing and calculate the correct position size, considering the following three things. So the account size is important. The risk per trade, we have spoken about this before, and of course the distance between entry and stop loss. Yeah, and the formula is pretty simple. You can see this here. Position size is equal to account size times the risk per trade divided by the difference between entry and stop loss. Yeah, and you can see here the first example. We want to go long in Apple. Assume Apple is about 150, our entry should be 149, and the stop loss should be at 145. The account size here in this example is $3,000, and the risk should be something about around 2%. So then you can take the formula above, fill in all the numbers, and then you come to the conclusion that the optimal position size for this environment is 15 shares of Apple. Yeah, then let's make another example. Example two here. We want to go long in crude oil, and crude oil is quoting around $55. The entry should be at $60 and the stop loss is then 59. So the difference between entry and stop loss is $1 and the account size is $1,000 and the risk could only be 1%. Yeah, and you can again fill in all the numbers in the formula. And yeah, this leads to an optimal position size of 10 crude oil units, I would say, yeah, because it's not calculated for futures contracts, because one crude oil futures contract is 10,000 barrels, and this of course costs a lot more. So these are just the simple units. If you want to trade CFDs, contract for differences, then you can calculate your optimal position size with this formula pretty easy. And I think the most of you are trading Forex, so currencies. And here we have the third example. It's a short trade. So assume you want to trade euro dollar and euro dollar is quoting around 115 and your entry should be 140.50. Then the stop loss should be 140.90. Of course, this is just hypothetical. Yeah, yeah, it's not must be. So it's just a calculation example. And the account size for the last example is, let's say, $1,000, and the risk should be 2%. Yeah, again, you can fill in all the numbers in the formula, and you come up with a optimal position size of 5,000 units of euro dollar. And 5,000 units are 0.05 lots, or in other words, 5 microlots. So 5 microlot would be the perfect position size to making this trade with this kind of stop loss, entry level, account size, and risk. Any questions regarding this? Because I see somebody's typing.
Yeah, I see as well. Hans-Peter Ross. Yeah, Hans-Peter. Just try to type anything.
I'll just wait for him. Okay, just to clarify a few terms, I have started reading into account relatively recently. Entry equals standing at which I enter the market. Correct, absolutely correct. Stop loss is standing at which I automatically pull out. Yeah, that's correct. So maybe the first recommendation we can give you is, if you enter a trade in which market ever, so it depends on you. And therefore, the stop loss level you can lose in conclusion to your money management.
I think Matthias, he didn't get your last sentences because the voice was off.
Okay, for you too?
Yeah, it would be fine. Yes, it was off. I didn't hear you. Okay. But it was completely off, you know, because I seen on the screen that also my voice was away.
Okay, so let me repeat this. Hans-Peter was absolutely correct. So the entry level is the level we want to enter the market, and the stop loss is a specific level in the chart where the stop loss makes sense. And the distance between entry and stop loss, this is the money we are able or we are happy to risk. And everything is fine for us because our risk and optimal position sizing is in this kind setup that we don't lose more than we want to. Okay, hopefully this helps. If not, please ask again so I can repeat it again, or maybe describe it in other words.
Oh, he's asking a question. In that case, one Q about risk.
I don't understand that, or I don't know what does it mean. In that case, one Q about risk, so the Q is not clear to me. And this, yeah, the entry and stop loss, this is just hypothetical. So you can ignore these numbers. It's just the base for the calculation here. So I just wanted to show you a calculation. Isn't
Yes.
risk the amount we lose? Therefore, if we enter a 60 and possibly exit at 59, that would be a 6 as a risk. Yeah, this is true, but you have to consider your account size and your risk you want to take. So, for example, if you change the risk should be to, let's say, 2%, then you can trade double the position size. So not only 10, 10 units of crude oil, then you can trade 20 units of crude oil. Well, let's say everything is equal, so 1,000 account, 1% per risk, but the stop loss is not at 59, but it is at 58. Then the optimal position size is not 10 anymore, because then it becomes less, and it is only the half. So it's only 5 units of crude oil. So everything here is connected to each other, and therefore you have this formula to calculate the perfect position size. Ah, okay, question. Okay, yeah, makes sense, absolutely. Okay, perfect. Then let's go over to the next topic and to all the others. If you have any questions, please don't hold back. So just shoot out and let us know in the chat box. So, yeah, the next myth I would say is the leverage, because I would say 99% of all beginners and maybe 50% of all traders in the world have a wrong imagination or a wrong expectation about leverage. They misunderstand leverage completely. And most of them say something like, oh, the leverage is so important. I only want a broker with a high leverage. But this is, sorry to say that, this is bullshit. You don't need a broker with a high leverage. You only need a broker, or in general, a big leverage, if you want to make a lot of trades simultaneously, or if you want to trade very large positions under a very small time frame with very tight stops. Yeah, for example, you want to trade a minute chart or maybe a tick chart, something like that. Then, of course, your stop loss is very close to your entry level. And this, leads to a very large position size. And only for very large position sizes, you need a large leverage. And yeah, that's it. So, for example, you remember these examples here. Yeah, the first example, Apple stands at 150, your account size is 3,000. And the optimal position size here was 15. Yeah, and the entry level is 149. So now you can easily calculate what is the nominal value of this? And the nominal value is only 150 times 15. And this is less than $3,000 on your account. So, in other words, for this trade here, you don't need any leverage. Yeah? The leverage you need is less than one. Go back to the second example we had here. So, crude oil. So the perfect position size here was 10. And if you want to trade 10 units of crude oil, and crude oil is quoting around 60, then of course you need $600 to make this trade. and your account size is $1,000. So in this particular example here, you don't need any leverage. So it's completely the same. It is a different story here in the third example. You want to trade 5,000 units of euro dollar. And yeah, it's quoting around 115. Then it is more than your account size is, because the account size is 1,000 and the nominal value of the trade is something around 3,700. Yeah. So only in the last example, you would need a leverage, otherwise not. So yeah, here you can see example one requires a lever. The lever is another word for leverage of 0.75. The example two requires a lever of 0.06. And the last example, sorry, I said something around 3,700, but it is indeed 5,700, so a little bit more. But far, far away from a leverage of 50, 100, 200, or 400. So some brokers are offering you a leverage of 400. And this, in my eyes, in my opinion, is not a quality characteristics from a broker. So the broker should only offer you, yeah, let's say 50 or 100 leverage, and you will never use this high leverage, but this is okay. So the leverage in my eyes is very much overvalued, and most people and most traders don't understand the importance of leverage, because they say it is important, but the truth is it is not important. The money management determines the position size and everything which is important, and not the leverage. Yeah, this is very, very important. Was this clear to you?
For me, yes, thanks.
Okay.
And yes, it was. As well.
Perfect. Okay, then the next one. So it's about leverage again, but this is, I promise you, the final comment I want to make about the leverage. Suppose we have a leverage of 400 and an account size of $500. Yeah, in theory, we could trade position worth $200,000. Yeah, it's 500 times 400. The result is $200,000. Yeah, but the leverage always works in both directions. So of course you can make money very quickly, very fast, but you can lose a lot of money in a very short period of time as well. So if you are trading a position worth $200,000 with a $500 account, and the underlying is moving only 0.01%, so it's a very tiny move in the market against us, we lose 40%, yeah, or $200. And this hopefully makes absolutely sense to you to say, I don't need a high leverage. Yeah, it's all about money management. You have to calculate the right position size for your trade, and that's it. Yeah, we do not have a worry about the leverage, but only about the position size and the money management. Yeah, this is very, very important. Okay, back to another one. So now I need your interactivity here. So because I want to ask you something, just to show you how your brain is working. And what expectations do you have? Is it correct or is it not? Is it overestimating or underestimating? Yeah, this is what I want to make now, and I just need your interactivity. So type in your expectations, and then I think it's also a little bit fun. So which system would you like to trade? System one with a hit rate of 60%, system two with a hit rate of 80%, or system three with a hit rate of 30%. So Which system would you prefer? Or maybe your answer is, I don't prefer any system. This is up to you. Yeah. So just shoot out. Use the chat box. I'm curious about your answers. I'm probably not supposed to say system two, but as a newbie, I will. But it might depend on other factors what the actual choice would be. Perfect. Perfect. Yeah, this is an A, graduated as a good trader. Perfect, Hans-Peter. Yeah, it's absolutely correct. So it depends on other factors. You cannot say system one, system two, or system three is the best one. Yeah, it makes absolutely no sense to say that because other factors are much more important. Let's go here to this slide. So it's not just about the hit rate. And the hit rate alone does not say anything about the probability of success of a system. Important is the average expected value of a trade in the system. So this value, yeah, the expected average value of a single trade must be positive, otherwise it makes no sense to trade a system. Absolutely correct, Hans-Peter. So for example, system one has a hit rate of 60%. Yeah, on the first sight, this seems very profitable. But let's say the average profit, which occurs with a probability of 60%, makes a profit of $4. And the average loss trade, yeah, which occurs with a probability of 40%, has a loss of 5%. Yeah, then the average expected value of each single trade is positive with 40 cents. And you can see the formula below. Calculation is just to calculate all the possible winnings with the probability of success. So $4 times 60%. And then minus the loss times the probability of loss. Yeah, and this here comes to the result of plus 40%. So the expected value of the first system with this kind of numbers I have here, so is plus 40 cents, and this is positive. So you can trade this kind of system, but of course we have some other ones. So for example, the second system, which on the first side was the best one with a hit rate of 80%. But we don't need, or but we didn't know anything else about the system. But now, so let's say the average profit is $2. Yeah, so in 80% of the trades, we have an average win of $2, and the average losing trade is $9. Yeah, you can make the same calculation, and yeah. The result is negative. So we have an expected value of each trade with this system here of minus 20%. And it makes absolutely no sense to continue with this system because we are losing in each trade around 20 cents. Yeah, it makes absolutely no sense to trade this system. And finally, you see system three. Only a very small hit rate of 30%, but you earn $7 each time you make a winning trade, and you lose only $1 if you have a losing trade. Of course, for your psyche, for your trading psychology, it is very hard to have a system with a 30% win rate and a 70% losing rate. But this is usually a trend following system in trading. A trend following system in trading has usually a hit rate of 30% and a losing part of 70%. Now, calculating all these things together, then you see the expected value of each trade is $1.40. And this is positive, and of course, system three. Is the best one out of these three examples here. Does it make sense to you, or any questions about this?
Everything seems to be clear.
Okay, but somebody is typing, so I just want to wait for him.
It makes sense.
Two questions. How do I know what hit rate a system has? Usually, you can see this if you read something and the author or the editor is saying the hit rate is 40%. Yeah, then it doesn't mean nothing to you without knowing what is the average winning trade and what is the average losing trade. And then you can put all the things together and you will know your expected value of a trade. Do I learn that by experience, or is there an indicator for that? Usually you have maybe a back test, or you can make a back test yourself, going back to the past and making some simulated trades. And if you have a number of trades, so let's say a sample of 100 trades, then you have your results and you can evaluate this numbers and you will know if this system or this strategy is running well or not. So I would say at least 100 trades from kind of back test, and then you have all these numbers. Okay, then the final slide, and this is my favorite one. Yeah, because a lot of traders have false expectations about the return on investment, about what is possible, what not, and what does a drawdown mean, and things like this. So I want to ask you in a kind of mind game four questions, and I'm very curious about your answers. So the first one is, how much starting capital is needed to have 1 million in 30 years if you have an annual return of 26%? So of course, I know this is just a guessing game, but I want to make this guessing game with you. So please don't use a calculator. So just shoot out, what kind of number do you have in mind? What do you think? What starting capital is needed to get 1 million in 30 years with an annual return of 26%? What do you think? Don't be shy. Yeah, there are no wrong answers. Yeah, it's just a game. $50 is the first guess. Okay, another one. Timo, what would you say?
I would guess this one. I would type
30. Okay. But we are ending at 1 million. And we are starting only with 30 or 50 bucks? Okay. No, the right answer is $1,000. Yeah. You need to have $1,000, and you're making 26% per year, 30 years long, then you end up with 1 million. Yeah, without any additional savings rates or so. So if you start with $1,000 today, and maybe you are only 25 years old or so, then you have 30 years left to have 1 million in 30 years. Okay, yeah, then the next one. So what is the average weekly return to achieve a yearly return of 26%? What do you think? So you need to make 0.1% per week, 1% per week, 0.5. Okay, good. Another guess. So 0.5, I can tell you that. So it's pretty close to the perfect solution.
It to the perfect
I'm pretty
pizza.
sure. So Timo, you only divided 26 through 52 weeks, and then you end up with 0.5.
Yes, correct. So why not?
It's fair enough to have this number for just a guessing. But I would honor here Hans Peter, because Hans Peter say a number which is slightly lower, and this is correct because we have here the compound interest effect. And through this effect, we don't need to make 0.5% weekly to achieve 26% a year. So in numbers, this is a wrong number. So this is correct. So 0.44%. So of course, in terms of difference, you are much closer, Timur. So the point goes to you. But in terms of recognizing the compound interest effect, I would say Hans Peter also has a point.
Okay.
Okay. Then over to the next thing. So what would be your final capital if you double your money every year for the next 20 years and you starting with $1,000? What is your final capital after these 20 years? What do you think?
Oh, shit. That's a huge number.
Yeah, it seems to be, but Hans-Peter, what do you think? Without using a calculator, so I'm a little bit scared that you need a lot of time to answer in here, so don't cheat us, please.
Let me type.
Just thinking it through, okay, about maybe $1 trillion, 400. Okay, yeah. Yeah, we are ending up over $1 billion. Dollar. So it's
Ooh.
Far away from a trillion, but I think we are, yeah. You are pretty rich if you're making this every year for 20 years. I can't say that. So $1 billion is the final capital after 20 years, starting with only $1,000. So this is just to give you an idea what is possible and what not. Of course, in my eyes, it is not realistic to think you can double your money every year, but this is only to give you an idea what would be the final. And of course, you don't need to be becoming a billionaire, but you see everything is possible if you, let's say, make 30% a year, yeah? Or the final question, your mind game four, in my eyes, is a very, very realistic approach or assumption. So let's say you are starting with $5,000, earning or making a return of 15% every year, which is very, very realistic. And you are making a monthly savings rate of only $100. Yeah. So this is, I would say, the perfect setup. It's very, very realistic. So $5,000, 15% a year, monthly savings rate of $100. What is the final capital after 30 years? What do you think?
I think I have to write a doctor exam, huh?
No, it's just a guessing game, so you don't need to calculate something. It's just a guess. $2 billion?
No, I say
one. $1 billion?
No, I say 500 million.
500 million, yeah. We are only starting with $5,000 and we are only making 15% a year. Okay. Good. Then let's see the correct answer. And the correct answer is $853,000. Yeah. So yeah, it's probably overshoot a lot here. Correct. So as I said before, this is a very realistic example. Yeah. So a lot of people have $5,000, and it is not a rocket science to make 15% a year, and maybe to have a savings rate of $100 a month. So if you have all of this, then you end up after 30 years close to a million, much, much better than ever insurance you can select. And maybe you are able to make more than 15% a year. So let's say 20, 25, or even 30% a year. Then, of course, the number here is much bigger at the end. Okay, yeah. So this is it basically from my side. Any questions regarding
Matthias,
the, yeah?
thanks at first for the presentation. Before we start to answer the questions from the attendees, I want to let you know, and also the attendees, today we will have a second webinar, about the Certified Derivative Trader course or program from Tradimo. Everything you need to know about derivatives. So it's a very, very good opportunity to attend there. It will start in 45 minutes. So if you have got time, just take the chance and the opportunity to attend there. Let me give you the link where you can do the registration. And because in this webinar, the coach Stefan Tötzke, the guy who is doing the Certified Derivative Trader program, will present the whole program and also answer all the questions about the Certified Derivative Trader program. So it's the best. So these seats are limited. So hurry up if you want to attend, because I would say the asking about this webinar is very high at this moment. So this is what I wanted to tell about it.
Okay, yeah, thanks for this little advice. Okay, Hans-Peter is there as well, so pretty cool. And one more question. In an early example, account of $500 leverage 400. So let me go back to this slide. Here we are. Position size of two. No, this is not a position size. Maybe this here is the thing. So it's just the nominal value we are able to trade. So we are able to trade a position which is worth $200,000 with a $500 account and a leverage of 400. How is it possible to trade that much with an account much lower than that? It is, in theory, it is possible, but we shouldn't do that because of the high risk. If the trade is running against us, we are losing very quickly a lot of money, and therefore it is necessary to calculate the perfect position size. We have made this in these slides before. So for example, here, yeah. You need to calculate your perfect position size, and then the leverage doesn't matter. Is one taking up debt to make this trade? Yes, correctly. So for example, let's take this one here. You are able to trade a position worth $5,700 and your trading account size is only 1,000. So in this particular example, you have a kind of loan from the broker, and yeah, you need to pay for that. So you have cost of carry or borrowing your money, and you have to pay for it, of course. And the lower the leverage or the smaller the position size you have, the lower the costs are, the fees in this case.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
What about your exit point? Let's take example two. I will type out my example one moment, please. Yeah, take your time. So, example two, it was this one. Yeah, so the take profit or the exit point, yeah, it depends on if you have a stop loss, which is for reducing losing more money, or the take profit is usually to make the money. But of course, I want to wait for your final description about this question. And let's say we go up $65, and now it starts going down again. Should I readjust my stop loss? How to do that effectively by taking into account my risk? This depends on your style. So in most cases, it makes absolutely sense to move your stop loss if you are in a long trade to a higher level if a new swing low appears. And if no newer or higher swing low appears, then in my eyes, it makes absolutely no sense to move the stop loss. But this, to be honest, has nothing to do with money management or position size or the topic of today's webinar, in other words. Yeah, to moving and to managing your stop loss is a different story. But please be careful at the beginning of a trade. What is your initial stop loss and your initial risk? This is very important, and you need to consider this, yeah, when you enter a trade. You're welcome. You're welcome. Okay, any other questions?
So I wrote the topic once again about the webinar today in the evening. So if anyone wants to attend, enjoy it.
Many about trading in general, but no more about money management. Thanks. Okay, so maybe you have watched the two recent webinars last Tuesday and the week before on Tuesday. So we had the topics of four reversal pattern and the five best indicators. So maybe you have watched this as well. Yeah, next week and the week after that, every Tuesday we will have here an English webinar about a specific topic. Yeah, you can rewatch this because it was recorded. And I think Matthias K, the other Matthias from the TradeMo team, has sent out a newsletter with all the recordings last Friday. So if you are not a member of TradeMo yet, so yeah, I would recommend to become a TradeMo member, and then you can see all these recordings. Yeah, check your email if you're already a member, then you have it, I'm pretty sure. If not, please let us know and write us an email to support@trademo.com. And of course, we can give you all the recordings we had in the past. Okay, cool. Yeah, I don't see any further questions. Timo, do you want to say something about other services we have, or
I can
you're
tell it
finished?
all to everyone. Yeah, at first the webinar will start in 40 minutes. So if you want to attend, I send out the link in the chat box. So I would be very happy to see you once again today in the evening. The second is, yeah, at first, thanks, Matthias, for the presentation about the whole topics, about the con about the leverages and the money management, the golden rules. But I can tell to everyone, yeah, this is only a small part what Tranimo is just showing about the complexity about about trading and exchanges, currencies, shares, and so on. And I can recommend to anyone here, if you are interested to get more informations, yeah, just to get the premium access of Tradimo. So let me send you the link. And I think, Matthias, we have got a very good campaign. I think, yeah, Matthias, I think you can correct me. 6 weeks for 6 euros instead of 49 euros per month.
No, I think this ended in the end of December.
Ended in December. Okay.
Yeah, but we have a current promotion running. Have you spoken to Matthias K to clarify such things?
Unfortunately, not this part.
Okay, because I don't know anything about this because I'm the
Yeah.
content man and I don't know anything about a promotion.
Okay, but I can tell to anyone here or to everyone, just click on the link, get the registration of premium, and upgrade this, and then you will get the whole universe of knowledge, what you need to know about, yeah, start your trading, be profitable, and changing your life, of course.
And for example, here my trader mode, and here you can see if you want to become a premium member, then you can select your nano diploma and you can be a part of our chat and signal community, which you can see here. So premium DE or premium EN discussion, premium EN signal. Here you have all the trades we are making in our $100,000 real money account in real time. And you can discuss this with us and other traders. And yeah, so this is it about the premium service.
Just take the chance, of course.
Okay, so I would say that's it. So I don't see any further questions. And yeah, then I will see you in the latest next week.
Yeah, very good. Thanks for your presentation, Matthias, and see you
Yeah.
again or hear you again.
Yeah, of course. Bye.
Okay, bye.